Good evening. I'd like to begin by saying congratulations to the 8th grade class of 2017, not only just for graduating, but for their terrific speeches tonight. Could we give them one more round of applause? They really did do a really good job on their speeches. I'm very proud of you guys. I am truly honored to be here with you tonight. I have gotten to know these students very well over the past couple of years, and they and this school hold a very special place in my heart. I promise that my speech tonight will be short. Someone once said that blessed are the short-winded, for they will be invited back. Graduation is one of those few times in our lives where we look forward and backwards same time. Graduates, tonight, as you realize that you are graduating from 8th grade, it causes you to look back on your time here at Vision Wing. You think about all the different classes that you've taken. You think about the homework, the projects, the tests, the quizzes. You think about all the things that you've learned, things that your teachers hope you still remember, although you may not actually remember it. You think about the teachers that you've had, the ones who have molded you and encouraged you and loved you and helped you become who you are today. You think about the friendships that you have and the class trips that you've gone on, the inside jokes, the laughs, some of which we've heard tonight, the stories that you'll remember for the rest of your lives. But graduation is also a time where we look ahead. You look toward your future and dream about the possibilities that lie in front of you, the goals that you have for high school. And as you transition to high school, things can kind of get a little crazy. In a few short months, you'll be heading to a much different, much larger school every day instead of this building. In a few months from now, you'll have some new friends and possibly lose some of the ones you have now. In a few months from now, you'll have interests and likes that you don't even have right now. And some of the things you're interested in today won't matter to you in a few months. During this transition, things can get kind of crazy. And oftentimes, things get lost in the shuffle. You know, that phrase, lost in the shuffle, means that something or someone doesn't get the attention that they deserve. We're going to do something a little unorthodox, and I need a volunteer for that. And so I picked Trey already. He knows this ahead of time. So Trey, come here for a second. I just picked him because he's first. He's right next to me. We're going to do a card trick. And you're going to have to just trust Trey that he's not in on this. You're not in on this, right, Trey? Trey knows he's not in on this. He wouldn't lie to any of you. Trey, if you would pick any card that you want. All right, go ahead and look at that card, Trey, and then show it to the graduates here, show it to everybody else. I promise I won't look. And you let me know when I can turn back around. All right, put that card in there. All right, so he put his card in the deck, and now I'm going to be able to find your card. Okay, if you just think about your card. Okay, think about your card and think about other things. Okay, focus just on your card. You're going to have to watch because nobody else can see. They're going to have to trust you because they don't trust me, probably. All right, I'm just flipping over cards, and I'm trying to figure out which one is his card because he's supposed to be thinking about his card. Don't think about other things. Think about just your card, okay? Trey, is that your card?
Yeah.
Was that his card? That one's his card?
Yeah.
Okay. That's a pretty easy trick if you don't already know it, if you don't already know what's going on. What happens is when he picks out a card, and I turn my back. I split the deck, and I look at the card that's here. And when he puts his card back down, I know that his card is the card right after the card that I saw. So it's kind of cheating. But we'll do it again, and we'll make it much harder. Okay, Trey, pick a different card. That'd be kind of cool if you picked the same card. Okay, now look at that card, and show everybody else that card. And we'll do it again. All right, go ahead and put it in there. Now, you're thinking, yeah, I know exactly where it is. I do. I know what this card is because I cheated and I looked. So I know what card's after your card. But we're going to make it harder, okay? We'll shuffle the deck. All right? We'll shuffle the deck and we'll mix up the cards. Now, think of just your card, and I'm going to find your card for you, okay? All right. Are you thinking of your card? Is that it? Is this one in? I have no idea what your card is. Hey, let's give Trey a round of applause. Thank you. It would have been really awesome if I could have known which card was Trey's in that second trick. But I couldn't because I lost it in the shuffle. When he first put his card down, I knew where his card was because I knew the order of the deck. I knew what card was right before it. But then as I shuffled the deck, everything started to change. Everything got mixed up and out of order, and it wasn't the way that I had planned it to be. It wasn't the way that I was used to it being. I lost his card in the shuffle. Hey, graduates, don't lose Jesus in the shuffle. This period of transition, of going to high school, there's a lot of things that are going to change. And although you might start going to a different school, you might have a different friend group, you might have different interests, your connection to Jesus can stay the same. This period of transition is marked by excitement, happiness, sadness, confusion, worry. But you don't have to lose Jesus in the shuffle. You know, in the book of John, chapter 15, verse 5, it says, Jesus said, I am the vine, and you are the branches. If you remain in me, and I in you, you will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing. In order to not lose Jesus in the shuffle, you have to be intentional about staying close to him. Now, you can do that through reading his word, you can do that through praying, you can journal, you can notice him in nature, you can listen to worship music, you can even get closer to Jesus by serving others. And there's a whole bunch of other things you can do, but the point is to be intentional about staying close to Jesus. When you do that, you will find that your relationship with him improves. You will have greater success in school. You'll be more secure in your identity as a child of God, and you'll be ready to face the challenges that await you in high school. So be intentional, and don't lose Jesus